Houston station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Dan Hewitt. What a way to end this decade in spaceflight. Boeing's CST-100 Starliner successfully returned after its first voyage to outer space. The mission started with a smooth ride uphill atop an Atlas V rocket, but experienced an issue shortly after separating. After flight controllers righted the spacecraft and put it in orbit, it was determined they wouldn't be able to successfully rendezvous and dock with the space station. But resolute to still accomplish as much as possible on the demo flight, teams executed a number of checkouts before guiding the capsule to a picturesque nighttime landing in frigid White Sands, New Mexico. It was a thrilling end to a jam-packed year for the International Space Station. In addition to Boeing's first Starliner flight, SpaceX conducted their first flight to and from the International Space Station earlier this year with their new Crew Dragon vehicle. Both flights continue to push us forward to once again launching crews to the station from America, with 2020 lining up to be the year we make it happen. Throughout the year, we saw three crews fly to the station on the Russian Soyuz, where they performed 11 spacewalks and welcomed 9 cargo vehicles from Northrop Grumman, SpaceX, Russia, and the Japan Aerospace Exploration Agency. And between it all, they worked on hundreds of experiments and technology demonstrations that benefit humans back on Earth and lay the groundwork for our mission to land the first woman and the next man on the moon under NASA's Artemis program. With all those accomplishments in the books, 2020 is poised to be a hallmark year in station history. We'll hit the ground running in January with spacewalks to finish battery upgrades and work on the Alpha Magnetic Spectrometer. While back on Earth, SpaceX will launch Crew Dragon on its in-flight abort test, one of the last major tests before putting humans on board. NASA astronaut Christina Cook will come home in February as the newest record holder for longest continuous spaceflight by a female astronaut, an inspiring end to her first mission. Then stay tuned for the first flights of astronauts with our commercial crew providers Boeing and SpaceX, the first time we'll send a crew to the station from the Florida coast since the space shuttle retired in 2011. And on November 2nd, we'll mark 20 unbroken years of humans living, working, spacewalking, experimenting, and flying in humanity's home, low Earth orbit. And that will do it for us in 2019. Thanks for following along and sending in your questions using the hashtag AskNASA. We'll see you next year.
Subscribe for more space.